With the release of Blender 3.2, it is now possible to easily bake out a texture image of each UDIM tile automatically with a few mouse clicks. What previously took a lot of manual stuffing around, or an add-on, can now be done within standard Blender. Let's find out how and what can be done to speed up the baking process. To demonstrate, I've taken the default monkey head UV unwrap and spread it across two UDIM tiles. Within the shading workspace, I've created a simple node setup which we are going to bake. For a successful bake, you are likely going to want to make sure there are no lights in the scene and that the world background is set to a light grey in order to provide even diffuse lighting. Next, we add an image texture node to the shader material. Then, clicking New, select the desired square resolution and tick the tiled checkbox. This tells Blender that it is a UDIM texture. There is no need to connect the image texture node to anything. Next, over in the image editor, select the new empty image we just added, and on scrolling out you can see the reference number to the first UDIM tile. However, we have a problem. Our UV layout uses two tiles. To solve that, press the N key to bring up the Properties sidebar and select the Image tab. Then, click the plus button to add a tile. In this case, we just want to add one more tile, so the defaults are fine. This leaves us with two blank UDIM tiles ready for baking. Next, click on the Render Properties and make sure the render engine is set to Cycles and device is GPU Compute. You can do this using the CPU, but it is very slow, so use a GPU if you can. Scroll down to the bake section, and for this example, we will change the bake type to diffuse. For contributions, uncheck both direct and indirect. We just want the color with no baked in lighting or shadows. Make sure the object you want to bake is selected, in case you have more than one object in the scene, and click the bake button. Depending on your render settings, more on that in a moment, Blender will soon bake out one texture and then another before displaying both in the image editor. If happy with the result, the tiles can be saved by clicking the stack icon and selecting Image Save As. Then, naming the file, but making sure to leave the UDIM code as part of the file name, and clicking Save As Image. On looking at the folder, two or more image files will now be present depending on the number of UDIM tiles set. Now we know how to bake UDIMs. Let's dive a little deeper into the settings that can affect the quality of the baked image and how long it takes to process it. Using cycles, there have been three main settings that determine bake speed: the number of samples, if denoising is turned on, and the memory tile size. In the past, changing the memory tile size has been an easy way to speed up bake times, so let's look at that first. Baking a 2K diffused color texture at 32 samples with denoise on at a memory tile size of 1K, 2K and 4K results in the same 33 second bake time. In fact, we can even turn the memory tile setting off and once again the bake takes 33 seconds. If we change the bake texture to 4K and test again at 1K, 2K and 4K and off, it takes longer at 2 minutes and 6 seconds, but they all take the same time. So while memory tile size may have mattered in the past, currently with Blender 3.2, it makes no difference at all. As such, all further tests are done with memory tiles on and the size set to 2048, since that is the normal default for Blender. This leaves us with two main settings, samples and denoising. So let's have a look at denoise first. Once again, we are baking a diffuse color only texture at 32 samples in both 2 and 4K resolutions. With denoise on, we of course get the same bake time as before. However, if we turn denoise off, the 2K bakes 7 seconds faster, while at 4K we save a whole 30 seconds. Looking at a zoomed in section of the 4K bake, we can see that they are both identical and noise free. While the denoising is taking time to do something, it's not actually doing anything which is visible. Great, I hear you say, just leave denoising off and save some time. Unfortunately, this is not always the case. While it's true for a diffuse color only bake, what happens if we change the bake type? On selecting the combined option from the bake type dropdown and processing at 32 samples with denoise off, we get a very noisy image. However, turning denoise on actually results in a very nice cleaned up and smooth image. So now you're all thinking, easy, if there's any noise, just turn on denoising to clean it all up. Unfortunately, that's not always the case. If we return to our previous diffuse bake type, but this time turn on direct and indirect, along with color, then at 32 samples, with denoise turned on, we actually get a very noisy image. Once again, using denoise does nothing but slow the bake process down, and as such, the only solution to clean up the image is to increase samples. At 64 samples, the bake is somewhat cleaner, but it still has visible noise. If this is the type of bake you are trying to do, then the only option would be to push up the samples and just wait for it to process. This in turn brings us to the subject of samples and how low you can go. If we return to our original bake type of diffuse with color only selected and denoise off, we see a non-linear increase in bake time going from 16 to 32 to 64 to 128 samples. As for the quality, video compression would remove any differences, but the 16 sample image has just a little more noise compared to the 32 samples, while at 64 samples, it is pretty much noiseless. 128 samples is basically a waste of time, especially if you are going to do further painting in a program like Critter. So, what have we learned? First, generally baking UDIMs in Blender 3.2 is pretty easy. Second, when it comes to bake settings, the memory tile size setting in cycles has zero impact, so just leave it at the default. As for the denoise setting and render samples, well, that gets a little bit messy. In general, depending on the type of bake you are doing, having denoise on will either have no visual impact on the baked image and just make it take longer to process, or it will clean up all the noise and allow lower samples to be used. In general, it is likely best to turn render denoise off, so uncheck it and only turn it on if the resulting bake image has a lot of noise to see if denoising will clean it up. In the case of render samples, a likely good starting point would be around 32, and then only increase it if the bake image has too much noise and turning denoising on doesn't work. That pretty well wraps it up for UDIM baking and a general look at the main settings that can impact bake speed and quality. If you like this technical overview and want to see more or have specific questions or requests, then please click the usual YouTube buttons and or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.